Yes. Okay. My main point about marketing is, first of all, be the absolute best at who you've decided you are. And probably the first thing before that is going to be to decide who you are. To decide what subject matter you like to do, what sizing you like to do. I like big, I like small. Everybody's going to have something that they really prefer doing. Do it, and do it well, and stand behind it. Don't do it. I'm going to say a few things that might make some people mad. I started off copying artwork, not artwork, but photographs out of National Geographic 35 years, 40 years ago. If there's any way you can get around that today, a digital, please do. Whatever it is you want to draw, please take a picture. Please take a picture. There's a big reason behind this. Not just because somebody else has taken that photograph, even if you ask them for permission to do it. If you take the photograph, you have a relationship with that right now. Whether it's a bowl of marbles, whether it's an iguana you see down by the river walk, whether it's a hibiscus blossom, you've seen it, you've been there, you have a story about it. You took it because it attracted you then, and you fell in love with it. And by doing something that you've seen, touched, felt, and taken a photograph of, you'll be able to transfer that love for that to your bio. If you don't, there's no way you can fake it. There's just no way you can fake it. So be totally and thoroughly involved with whatever it is you're going to be doing, if you're going to do it to market to sell it. And the reason to market it and to sell it is so you can support this addiction that you've got. Because every one of us is addicted to doing Scratchboard.
Oh, I can quit anytime I want. I just don't
want
to.
Right.
I just don't want to.
You
jokingly
told
new
Scratchers that they put something in the play, but
yeah, well, it's just like McDonald's and the Smith, and then once you start eating these, they're very much the same. So that's part of their whole marketing scheme, too, is you stop back just to get some more of these sometimes. But very, very seriously, that's the beginnings, and that's the beginnings of marketing. And then once you've established who you are, what size you want to do, then you have to sit back and say, how will this fit within my lifestyle? Am I wanting to work a 9-to-5 job, do this on the side, am I wanting to do this, which is what I did with my commercial art background, which dominated my life, and my fine art. And I just slowly did the shift. So yes, some of my commercial artwork is going into my making of my brochures, that's my website, and that type of thing now, but my primary interest is towards my fine art, discovery play, and all that. You have to look at kind of a plan, because if you don't have kind of a plan, you won't have a route to get there. So if you want to do it just as a hobby, so be it. If you've got something else that's going to be backing you up and going to be able to afford all your materials and supplies. Otherwise, if you want to do it really, if you want to grow, if you want to travel more, if you want to go to other artists' workshops all around to learn more, etc., that takes money, it takes cash, and it takes selling what you can do best, which should be your art. You can do it any number of ways. I said I want Kathy here because Kathy's doing some things that I'm just a beginner at doing. And I've done it in many ways through my commercial artwork, through sign painting, like I mentioned on the way up. That was kind of, you know, a hobby that I came my way through. I was lucky enough way in the very beginning, and it takes some huevos, which is the Mexican version of balls. A neighbor of ours asked me to come over and help him hang some artwork. I did is prints, open edition prints, a scratchboard printed in Sepiaton. Again, we're going back 40 years. And I saw them and I said, holy crummy, I didn't know anybody did this. And I flipped them over and found out who published them on the back of the pieces. And they were right, actually only less than an hour away in Chicago, that area. And so I picked up the telephone and said, and called them, because the number was on there, and said, you know, I do scratchboard too, but I do it in full color. saw my stuff and we published it. And we had neat little ideas. I never would do just one of something for the open edition market. I did 6 panels of flowers in the Oriental Japanese style so that people could buy 1, 2, 3 or the whole thing of them and hang them so that one sale would grow into being 2 or 3 on them. Same thing, I did a whole woodland series where I would have different sizes where you could start off with a few small pieces and then add a medium-sized piece to it and it could grow into a whole wall area of things. That's multiple money. That's doubling down. That's getting more out of the market. After that time period, I wanted to grow and do more intricate things. That's what I did with my clinical studies that a lot of people are starting off to do right now, by the 7s, 8, 10s, 9, 14s. And I wanted to do the full size board from Essex Scraper Board at the time. And we have one of those old things working right now. I was going to use it later on just to show. And that's what I'm cool about. Because this thing took 6 months to do it. And it wasn't 6 months all at the same time, obviously. It was getting very tired of coming back to it over and over and over again. But it was my first fully cut board. And I did call it Still Waters after the song that I prayed an awful lot to make it through it. You know, that I would come back to it and get it finished. And this was kind of the first pieces that I published myself because it was done as part of the woodland thing and my publisher didn't want to publish it. So I set out to figure out, the local flowers. Oh, it's just some of those landmark things for me. Getting through it.
You have a
conversation on
the hundreds of hours you spent
on 200 hours. Because in the old days, what I did was, I did TikToks on the side, because I was curious as to how many hours I was spending.
That's as far as
it goes
down.
Thank you.
I got that.
So I did
about 13 different prints. Now that marketing is totally different because you're marketing other galleries at that time. So we had to travel and do trade shows at that time, professional picture framers, and our writer Carol all over the country with the reproductions and the originals too. But we pushed the reproductions, and what we did was start up like a little inner circle where if a gallery wanted a certain number, they had to go with the same number of everything. So we had select galleries that were certified Renaissance galleries that carried out prints. Other ones that could order. And it entailed a lot of advertising and trade publications and that type of thing to do it. Tremendous experience for me on business, bookkeeping, contact, but still didn't get end user.